Assalamu alaikum. Today I'm gonna be showing you. It's a very difficult video, this one, because I've been thinking of doing this for a very long time, and sometimes it hits you, and then you've got no choice but to deal with something like this. Now, I recently had a death in the family, and I had to deal with preparing the shrouding fabrics and so on. Now this is one thing that we are all going to have to face, and the one final ending that we're all going to have, and some of us will not be even fortunate enough to even be blessed with the shroud. Now it is a very difficult topic to handle, and I'm finding it difficult to find the words on how to actually address this and how to go about showing you what you will require. But I think it's essential to make ourselves aware of what will be required and to prepare in advance, because when none of us are ever prepared, and sometimes it can just strike you, death strikes us with a shock. And then we have to still run around and prepare all the things that are required, and it just makes it even more difficult. So basically what you need is cotton fabric. This is pure cotton, and I had to go out and purchase this on the day. Generally when I had the shop, I did sell this, and when I sold the shop, I just gave it away, and I wasn't prepared. But I had to quickly go and buy all the necessary fabrics and so on. Now, what I will do is I will attach a video. I will attach a link to everything that's required. And what I would suggest is, whenever you can pluck up the courage, you know, just prepare the things in advance rather than leaving it to last minute and then, you know, running around frantically trying to find what you require. So what's required for a man? I'm just going to give you a demonstration for a man, and then hopefully you'll have some idea. And there's a few additional pieces that you require for a woman. So it's four different pieces. The first one is just these strips of fabric that's to tie the shroud fabrics over with, or the end body with. And you need three of these spread out. And on top of this is a sheet of fabric which is in length of, what I would suggest is lay this out in this manner, and then this goes, or gets opened up and goes straight into the coffin. And so what we need to do is just, I'll explain as I'm going along. So you need three of these strips, even them out, and lay them out on a flat surface, on the floor, anywhere. I've got a table, so I'm just going to demonstrate on the table. So this is just to tie the body up with after it's been shrouded. So just lay these straight, and then on top of this is a large sheet of fabric, and this is called the lifafa. Okay. The name for it is a lifafa. Now what you want is this opened up and laid out on top of the strips. So this sheet, you know, you just need to lay it out evenly. And what happens is a foot of this gets left at the top of the body, and a foot of this gets, it doesn't matter if it's slightly long, you can just slightly, you know, so lay this out. And then on top of this is another piece which is slightly smaller than this. Now I'll give the precise dimensions of these on the bottom of the video, so you have an idea. This is a big width fabric. So on top of this goes another sheet, and this one is slightly smaller than the first one. So what you have is, what you should have is like a couple of foot, well, about a foot and a half, or maybe 2 foot left from the top. And you just need to lay this on top, evenly on top of the first one. Okay, and then on top of this is the third sheet, which is the dress. Now the dress is, I'll just give you, explain what needs to be done on the dress. Okay. The dress has, the fabric has been halved and then is halved again this way. I've taken a small amount off because it was too wide. So basically what you want is the width from here all the way across the shoulders to the other side of the arm. So this fabric was too wide and I took some off from the side. And then I've just, I'll explain on a separate, here I'm trying to explain the layout of this. What I'll do is I will explain. So what you want is you want to lay this, the cut side, the opening side, you want to lay it to the far end because, so this just gets laid in sort of like the center. Like this. So what will happen is the body is laid out straight onto this, and once it's laid out, this piece then is taken over on top of the head, and the head is taken through that, and this is folded over, and once this is folded over, this will get, so what you have is you have the cut up of the neckline, the opening for the head, and this is a cut of approximately 12 inches down and approximately 10 inches across. So 12 inches down, 10 inches across, so that easily the head can be pushed through. So the way that this is cut is this fabric, this sheet was halved and then it was halved again, and then I took a cut of 12 inches down and 8 inches across, and that's all there is to it. There's no sewing, there's no fitting, there's no nothing. That's basically, that's all where you know, the person is dressed in. And then once this is done and the body is placed in here, the arms are folded over the chest, and what's going to happen is the secondary sheet, which is this one, is folded over like such from one side and the other side, and then the final sheet is folded over like this. That basically is it. These bits are turned over and they're tied up. Now there are some additional requirements, and I will put, you know, all the other towels and so on that are required. I'll put all the list of stuff that's required for washing the body with. But for the burial, that's the dress and that's basically it. And that's all. After talking about fashion for such a long time, you know what? This has been the easiest of outfits to make, and it's the one sure one that we're all going to be dressed in as our final attire. I hope you find the video helpful and it's not been too disturbing for anyone who's suffered loss in the family. My condolences and my sincere prayers are with you. Keep me in your du'as, and I hope to see you under better circumstances in the near future. Take care and bye.